Hi there, and thank you so much for joining me today. Today I'm going to be talking about the gorilla diet regimen for detoxification, for clearing toxins from the body. Sometimes the body may need some extra help in fighting off infections and strengthening the immune system, sometimes just getting rid of toxic metals that we have accumulated from all sorts of lifestyle habits that we may have or from environmental pollutants. We want to keep our skin healthy, and we want to increase our energy levels, and sometimes these are the best times to start a detoxification diet. Now, the gorilla diet detox is not merely a diet and weight loss regimen or a detoxification regimen. It's a complete dietary and lifestyle method that integrates detoxification into the process of everyday life. Now, the gorilla diet detox follows some specific guidelines, which are very easy to follow. So you'll see that they're very, very easy to follow. And there are six of them, to put aside the diet part of it. So the six of them are: number one is to eat peacefully. When you're sitting down at the table to eat, relax, take it easy, and enjoy your meal. Be at peace when you're ready to eat. Actually, could be at peace during the whole day, but especially when you're eating, to help in the detoxification process. Daily outdoor walks is another very important thing, because when you go outside and you increase the diversity of your microbe population in your gut microbiome, very, very important for detoxification and for health. Also, regular scrubbing of the skin, which not only helps remove toxins through the biggest organ in the body, which is 20 square feet of skin we have on our body, depending how big we are, of course, but that's the average. And regular scrubbing of the skin helps to remove toxins from the body, and it also improves circulation. Also, peaceful sleep at night helps in balancing hormone levels, which is very, very important. And daily sunshine to get enough of the vitamin D, which is very, very important in practically all of the bodily processes, because it's not actually a vitamin. So you can look it up under one of my other articles on vitamin D and its importance to our health. Also, adequate hydration, very important, of course, for detoxification. So in the gorilla diet, we approach detoxification as a natural part of a healthy lifestyle. Detoxification helps to remove any excess toxins, and it also helps eliminate free radicals and their damage from our body. Now, how food is consumed and when it is consumed is very, very important, as well as your food choices for detoxification. And regular meal times are critical. Eating regularly throughout the day is very, very important. Fiber-rich, whole natural foods like natural whole grains, legumes of all sorts, and vegetables. These are the focus of the detoxification process. Metabolism is also improved by the promotion of healthy circulation, physical activity, a positive, peaceful attitude towards life, and through the hydration and food choices. So you also have increased metabolism there, great for weight loss. And the detoxification process, although it is focused on elimination, it also needs to supply the body with sufficient nutrients to supply all of its needs and to help the body repair itself and heal itself from any disorders that we may be suffering from, as well as removing all of the excess waste. So waste can come from different places. Sources include air pollution, ongoing bodily functions also will produce waste, of course. Heavy metals that we get from the environment, air pollution, plastics, radiation, and our food, as well as our attitude. The more simple and natural our diet is, the fewer toxins we will have, although we will always have some kind of toxins in our body, because actually foods have these toxins in them naturally as a part of defending themselves from predators like us. Now, sluggish digestion also comes from consuming foods lacking in fiber. Therefore, the detoxification diet is very, very rich in fiber. We don't want a weak digestive system, which will have difficulty breaking down our foods, leading to fermentation in the gut and all sorts of negative effects that we don't want to have. So we're going to be consuming a lot of fiber in this diet. Now our intestines, the liver, the kidneys, and our skin, these are all detoxification organs, and our diet influences each one of these directly and critically. So many people assume that a detox diet is just a regimen that involves juicing and drinking lots of juice. Now, actually, I have found that there are many problems associated with juicing. First of all, when you use a common juicer, you're removing most of the fiber from your vegetables and fruits. So that is, of course, something very negative. But not only that, even if you are using a blender, the blender actually breaks down the cellulose and it provides more sugars into the food itself, which raises blood sugar levels, and it actually causes the pancreas to become overloaded and burdened. So we do not want to be juicing all of our foods, definitely not. We want to increase the fiber, and the fiber intake will reduce whether you are blending or juicing using any sort of method, especially if you peel the fruits and vegetables. But even if you don't, you will still be reducing the amount of fiber rather than consuming the whole fruits and vegetables themselves. So blending and juicing is not the best way for detoxification, and a much better way for detoxification is to follow a whole food cleanse, which is what the Gorilla Diet Detox System is about. When you detox with whole foods that are rich in fiber, following the Gorilla Diet guidelines, you are not only helping to eliminate toxins from your body, you are also nourishing your cells and significantly improving your health and also speeding up your metabolism. So only win-win-win, really a great situation. A whole foods detox is rich, as I said, in dietary fiber from vegetables, beans, and unprocessed, organically grown, soaked grains that have been soaked overnight and washed. This really, really helps, providing the best quality foods. The cleansing diet emphasizes consuming fresh and natural plant foods and sea vegetables as well over any animal products and, of course, processed foods. So the soluble fiber actually helps soak up any excess hormones, including estrogens and unhealthy fats, and helps them get out, helps our body remove them, eliminate them before they become absorbed in our body. And this is really great. It also affects the gut microbiome and regulates nutrient management and detoxification of the body. This has actually been proven in a study in Advances in Nutrition. Now, if done regularly, this cleanse will also delay aging, as I said, by increasing skin elasticity. Sea vegetables are great for that. There are some sea vegetables that I'll get into in just a minute that have collagen and actually really, really help improve the way we look. And also promotes healthy hair growth and will support health in every other way. It supports a beneficial cholesterol profile, and it resolves any nutritional deficiencies, improves the gut microbiome as well, and helps you get rid of any heavy metals that you've picked up from your day-to-day life. So how does the Gorilla Diet Whole Foods Detox work? Well, further to the six lifestyle habits that I mentioned before, I will now give you a diet plan for detoxifying your diet with high fiber whole foods. And also you can stretch it out over a period of 10 days if you wish with the additional foods that I will recommend that you can do changes in. So day number one, before you eat your breakfast, I want you to drink 3 cups of chamomile tea. This is very, very good for also giving you a relaxing state, putting you in a relaxing state. And it's also very, very beneficial for cleaning up toxins from the body. Then I want you to go and take a quick shower, scrubbing your body to remove any excess dead skin and help the circulation start going throughout the morning. Then I want you to go for a walk, a fast power walk for 30 minutes outdoors. Now, it doesn't matter if you live in a city and you don't have anywhere else to go. Even if you go outside, it's better than staying inside because there is a whole different diversity of microbes that are found outside and they aren't found inside any office buildings or even in our house. So even if you do go outside, you'll be increasing the diversity of your microbiome, which is very, very important. And if there's sun outside, you'll also be getting sufficient vitamin D, which is great. And you'll also be exercising, which will increase your circulation. So after you come back, whether you've gone to the station, done a power walk to get to a train station or get to work, after you get to work or whether you're still in your house, it's time to eat breakfast. Now for breakfast, you can have some brown rice porridge, which is just made from simple brown rice with hot water. You put plenty of water, much more than you would normally do, after it's been soaked overnight. And you can add to it some sesame seeds and cashews and some chia seeds to add to its nutrient density. You can drink a cup of Japanese green tea along with it, which is rich in antioxidants and it's very, very healthy. That's for breakfast. And for lunch, you can have any type of really legume soup. Split pea soup, lentil soup, whatever legume soup you wish to have, with whole wheat buckwheat crackers. Or if you don't find crackers, you can also use the buckwheat cakes, like rice cakes. They're round and you can find them in any health food store. These are also great. Now, alongside that, I want you to add any vegetable that you like. For example, steamed Brussels sprouts or any other vegetable, which is a green vegetable. And you can drink that along with green tea as well. Now for a snack, I want you to eat seasonal fruit. For example, watermelon, cantaloupe, any of the berries you can have. And apples are also great detoxifying fruits. And then for dinner, I want you to eat some kind of legume. For example, steamed tofu. Tofu is excellent because it's also fermented and has very, very many health benefits. And if you are afraid of the phytoestrogens found in the tofu, then look at my other video about the importance of phytoestrogens as part of a healthy diet. So you don't need to be afraid of the tofu. It's actually very, very good as part of a healthy diet. And you can have that along with some sea vegetables. I'll mention those in just a minute. These are very, very helpful, beneficial for thyroid function, and really rich in nutrients to support health and detoxification. Now you can drink that along with chamomile tea. And now for the fasting. After you finish your dinner, from the end of dinner time until your first meal in the morning, I want you to fast for 12 hours. It's an intermittent fast, which benefits you greatly. And it's actually how our ancient humans were living. They were actually fasting regularly for 12 hours. And this is what I want you to do as well. Incorporate it into your lifestyle. If you can't on a regular basis, at least do it during the detox. Now, after you've finished dinner and you've started your fast, you may drink at any time during the fast, no worries. But then before you go into bed, you go again into the shower, you scrub your body to remove any excess waste that may have gathered on your skin, and you're ready for day number two. Now, day number two is similar to day number one, just different choices of foods. Now, I'm not gonna go into a day-to-day regimen. You can find that on my blog at thegorilladiet.com. But I will tell you a few foods that you can exchange for the foods that I mentioned in this one-day detox regimen. And vegetables, for example, you can have some cabbage, bok choy, yams, cucumbers, carrots. You can actually change the fruit element that I mentioned in the detox as a snack. You can change it for vegetable sticks, for example, celery vegetable sticks, cucumbers, carrot vegetable sticks. These work great for detoxification. You can also, please also consume cauliflower, broccoli. These are excellent vegetables, as well as beets. You can grate up the beets and eat it. They are wonderful for detoxification and will keep you very, very healthy, rich in nutrients. Now, the sea vegetables I was talking about before. Arami is a brown seaweed, very, very healthy. Kombo, which is very, very popular. Miso soup is a great ingredient for natural detoxification. It's very, very rich in nutrients. Hijiki is another black seaweed that is a great sea vegetable. Agar can be used in desserts to thicken up anything that you want in a healthy way. Sea lettuce and kelp. Kelp is great, rich in iodine, all of these sea vegetables. There's also Irish sea moss, which is very, very rich in collagen, great for the skin, as well as seaweed in sushi. Now, as I said, tofu can be mixed as another legume. Black beans, edamame, and are great choices for different types of legumes. Now for seeds, you have sesame seeds, pumpkin seeds, excellent for detoxification. Cashews are also great nuts, and they also are rich in iron, very, very good. The grains, please soak them overnight, then wash them before you cook them. This will help them get rid of their own toxins and will make them easier to digest. Brown, of course, brown rice. Do not consume any white rice. Brown rice, buckwheat, whole buckwheat, millet, quinoa. All of these are great for detoxification, as well as barley and, of course, whole oats. You can also have some organically grown corn. And fruits, as I mentioned before, avocados, dates, all of the berries, watermelon, honeydew, cantaloupe, great. Now, the foods that you do want to avoid on your detox are dairy and meat products, refined sugars and sugar substitutes. You want to remove all processed foods from your detoxification days, as well as fried foods, and also chocolate, cocoa, butter, everything to do that has caffeine in it as well, including coffee. You want to try and get that out of your detox days. I know it won't be easy, but it will be well worth it. Also, try to exclude some tropical fruits. Now, by regularly eating this way, you are also improving your health. You are definitely getting rid of any excess waste products in your body, and you'll just be healthier and happier, more vibrant, more energetic as well. So that's it for today. I hope you liked this content. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you want more info on health and healthy eating, nutrition, anything to do with that, visit my blog on www.thegorilladiet.com. Thank you very much.